welcome back to Planetarium. And I think we're going to go a little further into the story. As we go into our next chapter, leaving the planetarium behind. On the next day, the rain continued to fall. It was as if it had been that way since the beginning of the world.
Planetarium はいかがでしょう?どんな時も決して消えることのない美しい不朽のきらめき。満天の星々が皆様をお待ちしています。
She continued to address the rain with her lucid voice as if nothing had changed.
こんにちは、お客様。お気分はいかがでしょう?
When she noticed me, she gave me the same salutation that she always did.
よくもないが、悪くもない。
そうですか。もしもまだご体調が優れないようでしたら、
大丈夫だ。
はい、それはよかったです。お客様はこれからお帰りですか?
ああ。
投影が不完全で本当に申し訳ありませんでした。心よりお詫び申し上げます。
いや。
I started for no particularly good reason.
お前の投影は悪くなかった。
お褒めいただき本当に嬉しいです。それにお客様にはいろいろと助けていただきました。本当にありがとうございました。
My grenade launcher, waterproof cloak, backpack all felt several times heavier than usual. Because the humidity in the projection room had risen due to the shutdown of the air conditioners, I could again feel the dull ache from several old wounds. I didn't even get a good night's sleep last night. I was all out of food, and I could feel that I would soon run out of strength. But none of these things were the cause of my current reflective mood.
No.
はい、何でしょう?
Just... What do you plan on doing from now? I took down the words I had been on the verge of saying. Completely senseless question. She'd be waiting without question or complaint on this rooftop for more customers to come, or for the staff members to return, or for the electricity to the projector to be restored. When her batteries were exhausted, she would connect her charging socket to its cable and simply close her eyes. And then she would never move again. That was a certain future that would visit itself upon her body.In the meter of it, a few dozen hours at the most.
お客様?
今日も客待ちか?
いえ、今日は水曜日ですので、当デパートは全館休業となっています。
休みってわけだ。
はい、お休みです。
休みはいつもどうやって過ごすんだ?
はい。私には休暇は必要ありませんので、細々とした用事をこなしています。
そうか。
前年の休業日には花束を作り直していました。8年ほど前に作ったものが壊れてしまいましたので。
あの花束だ。
はい。次は本物の綺麗な花束を用意してお待ちしています。
That dubious bouquet of artificial flowers had been cleared away from my sight some time ago, even without my noticing. The least I could do for her was to engage her one last time in the idle talk that she seemed to love so much. And I was in the middle of repairing the projector, I certainly thought that this might not be too bad for a place that this might not be too bad a place to die. But the feeling, which wasn't far from intoxication, was now vanishing like a fad from a bygone era. In this place was something that could be called a longing for others. I wanted to head toward the place where people still set foot and live their lives on this little planet, even if I should perish along the way. Yes, there was a part of me that felt that way. Even if it amounted to nothing more than a mere instinct that, from the very beginning, had been embedded in every single one of those living things known as human beings. Even so, yes, send all prayers to the great and mighty Tetsuwana. At that moment, she turned strangely serious. Her words, which had started off so cheerfully, trailed off in hesitance. Yes, there will be perils. Yes. Woo. Yes, there will be perils. I answered, thus lengthening the idle chatter that I had grown so used to. She replied thus, even though she knew that there was an electrical outage. That did not mean that she could necessarily string together the consequences of that situation. On my way in, during my battle with three other junkers at the rift in the quarantine wall, the engine of my motorcycle had been shot to pieces. The Land Rover that my three colleagues had come in was undamaged, but its three passengers were a completely different matter, fitting into a forced dealing. If I could successfully escape the city, then I could take that car and drive it to a nearby settlement. But if that car were out of gas, then I was destined to die a dog's death. Her rapid succession of questions were obviously very different from the idle talk that she was so fond of. She said with a dead serious voice, not answering my question. I cannot help but feel that there was something in that voice that I never heard before.
What?
I was just about to prod her for a second time when she returned to her usual smile. How was I supposed to respond to this? As I fretted over Hao's reply, she merely continued to smile. She cocked her head slightly. Pardon the yawning I've been doing. And once again, an incessant flood of words. There have been times when I had seen this kind of slapstick comedy on old-fashioned film reels. But when I first entered this planetarium, I came face to face with the genuine article. Great going there. She only used the phrase, I believe, during times when she was absolutely certain that her notions were correct. In other words, I would literally not be able to move her otherwise, not even with a lever. She clearly asserted. I sighed again. It seemed that I had underestimated her yet again. Or it may have well been that I have forever disrupted a garden that had heretofore been maintained in exquisite balance. Of course, I shouldn't have let her accompany me. Should have freed myself in the grasp of this broken robot and returned to the solitary life of a junker. However, her artificial optic resin eyes were sharply focused and gazing at me intently. My mind had been an empty desert and a clattering graveyard of hollow sounds. Indeed, that had been the world in which I have walked up until now. But now, grains of stardust were shining like a stain undying on an imperishably dark heart of hearts that had long been without a single decent thought. Seized by an impulse that I myself couldn't fathom, I armed my grenade launcher. Oh great, 4 more days.
はい、現在測地衛星による位置情報を取得しました。 情報が取得できませんが、現在位置から半径 3km 以内でしたら、どの場所からでも単独で帰着が可能です。
You're gonna do it, aren't you, bud? You're gonna do it, aren't you?
雨は大丈夫。
私の筐体は第2種業務防水仕様となっておりまして、
それは前に聞いた。雨に当たって動けなくなることはないのか。
はい、雨天下での行動に問題はありません。
Although she spoke with such confidence, the rain that fell now was completely different from the rain that fell 30 years ago.This whole class 2 waterproofing thing was dubious as well.
同行してよろしいでしょうか?
Finally, I answered her.
勝手にしろ。
ありがとうございます。
She bowed deeply to me.
それでは、参りましょう。
She produced something from the inside of her other reception desk. The thing she was presenting me with a huge smile on her face was that self-styled bouquet again. Just when I thought I'd seen the last of it, there it is, there it was again.
What's the matter?
花束です。大切にお預かりしていましたので。
So she would not be satisfied unless I took a souvenir with me after all. Was that it?
預かってほしいと言った覚えはないぞ。
はい、投影室内にお落としになられたようでしたので、こちらで保管しておきました。
落としたんじゃない、捨てたんだ。
8 hours versus 5 episodes. I'm in for the long haul, folks. In for the long haul.
はい、そうなんですか。
She replied thus. Her facial expression obviously told me that she understood nothing.
どうぞご安心ください。投影中にお荷物をお預かりするのは無料サービスとなっておりますので。
I then sighed again. Not at her kindness, but at the way that I was caving in.
持っていくなら勝手にしろ。俺は受け取る気はないぞ。
わかりました。お客様のお車まで私が責任を持ってお持ちしますので。
She responded thus to what I said.I couldn't help but feel that her ability to interpret my words to her utmost favor was quite incredible.
それから、今日の天気ですと傘が必要ですね。ただいま用意します。
As she briefly laid the bouquet down and turned to go back to the counter, I grabbed and stopped her. If I allowed her to have her way any longer, I would probably end up carrying everything in the kitchen sink.
傘はいい。コードがしてある。
I helplessly opened my backpack and took out my spare waterproof cloak.
いえ、そのようなわけにはまいりません。
ついてくるなら、せめて俺の言うことを聞け。
ですが。
ほら、着るのは自分でやれ。
I thrust a dirty cloak at her.
はい、それでは、お言葉に甘えまして。
She bowed low as if she were receiving a medal from me. Does that mean I'm going to get something out of this? The streets were empty. Shutters encrusted with rust and bicycles standing where they had been abandoned 30 years ago were being deluged by the rain. I flipped off the safety of my grenade launcher and slowly surveyed my surroundings. There was no sign of warmongers, nor there were any signs of pedestrians with their umbrellas. Nothing at all had changed since I had first arrived in this sarcophagus city. I was very strongly struck by the incongruous feeling that I was the only living being in this entire place now. It was the first time that I felt such a thing. She said, as if she were musing about the exact same thing that I was. I walked down to the street from the east, wearing the hood of my cloak low over my eyes. So I heard the sound of the rain hitting the road. The feeling of incongruity disappeared. At that moment, she seemed to hesitate over something. Crossed the main street without slowing down and then concealed myself near the opposite sidewalk. Finally, she began to cross swell. She walked with a relaxed gait, as if she were going shopping in the neighborhood. She whispered over to me and smiled. Just then a sheet of spray spouted up. She lost her balance and sprawled all in the middle of the road. Bracing herself with both hands, she arose in a smooth and refined manner. After that, she picked up the bouquet from the mud. She then continued to cross the road as if nothing had happened. Oh, she looks rather cute in that. She lightly bowed her head with complete calm. Her voice barely shrank down to a whisper. She confirmed, puffing out her chest proudly. She said earnestly, looking out at the depressed remains of buildings that seemed to lend credence to her words. Started putting together a plan of action. A little over 3 kilometers from here to the rift in the quarantine mall, at least that's the birth group. If she was going to continue to fall over in the middle of the road and scold me over traffic laws that ceased to be years ago, we could probably just barely reach the rift in an hour. However, the patrolling squads of heavy hunter-killer mechs made it dangerous to utilize the major roads. So it would be probably better to take a detour east and head toward the rift using the side paths. Even so, that was going to take several hours. She was the biggest problem here. If any one of the autonomous combat units spotted this ditz of a companion robot, she would not be able to produce a corresponding IFF signal and would thus be targeted as an enemy mech. While their scanners would not detect the signature of a living organism coming from her, there was no mistake that would pick up on her movements.
Okay. もし俺とはぐれたら心配せずにまっすぐに帰れ。
いえ、そういうわけにはいきません。
どっちの命令に対しての答えは？
はい、後者です。諸事情を勘案しますと、お客様を無事にお送りすることが私の使命だと考えます。
使命か。
I had heard those words spoken, being spoken so many times before in the past, but I never once met a person who had truly believed in them.
それに、実を申しますと、私は外出するのが好きなんです。以前は、よく街角に立って、通行人の方々に投影のお知らせをしたものです。
But she's doing a little more than that today.
プラネタリウムはいかがでしょう？
だから、余計な口を聞くなと言っている。
はい、申し訳ありません。
She allowed the next 10 seconds to pass in silence as if she were punishing herself for her trespasses. I was confronted with a problem that had no solution. Just what was I thinking, taking her with me like this? True that I could not for even a second think that it was permissible to leave her, to just leave her in that planetarium that had now lost all its faculties. But what other choices did I have?Hers was an existence that should have ceased to be 30 years ago. Just why did I care so much about this broken robot?
くそ。あの、お客様、ご気分が優れないようでしたら。
大丈夫だ。余計な心配するな。
はい。
Right. There was no time to be thinking about this kind of problem right now.Could not do anything about whether she was going to continue to exist or not with my hands alone. When the emergency struck, it would just be better to desert her. She wouldn't be able to catch up to me either. I didn't care what would become of her after that. I once again stepped out into the rain.In the space of 1 hour, I felt as if I had already done a decade's worth of penance. The air had grown chilly, and the rain was continuing to fall as it always had. Although the sidewalks were also immersed, they were not so bad so as to be unwalkable yet. It did not seem as if there were any combat units in the area either. If I made skillful use of the alleyways, the various road blockades would not be so much of a problem too.Yet I still found myself in the heart of this sarcophagus city.
ご覧ください、お客様。
She said happily, twisting her entire body. She looked around.
あちらのお店のバニラシュークリームはとても好評で、いつでも行列ができています。
Sure enough, there was a foam billboard on the side of the road that read, Delicious handmade cream puffs here. But the line which she spoke of was nowhere to be seen.Within the span of these 30 years, the baker's skill must have fallen considerably.
お客様はシュークリームをお好きですか？
好きも嫌いも食べたことがない。
そうですか。今はちょうど空いているようです。お土産に一つお求めになってはいかがでしょう。よろしければお得な割引券をご用意できますので。
Are you kidding?
行列もない。商品もない。
As I said this, she looked with wonder at the refrigerated case that now only had a price tag sticking on it.
そうですね。残念ですが、品切れのようです。
She said this as if nothing unfortunate had happened at all.
案内はいいから、もっと早く歩いてくれ。急いでた。
はい、承知しました。ですが、今日は地面が濡れていますので、あまりお急ぎになりますと。
And just as she said that, one of her feet got snagged on the junction between two tiles. Just like that, she lost balance and tumbled to the ground with a crash. The bouquet flew from her hands and parts of the flowers scattered about. She did not cry out, nor did she clutch any parts of her body in pain. It was almost like silent comedy. She got up in a single smooth movement and then picked up the fallen bouquet with conscious air. Yet you look at them and they're still there. They're broken, but yet they still exist. Look at that. As if nothing in the past couple hours had happened, she stepped up to a large fluorescent billboard.
こちらのビルの5階には、塔でパーと提携のビアホールがございます。新鮮な魚介料理とともに、様々な地ビールをお楽しみになれます。今でしたら、お得な飲食割引券が印刷できます。よろしければ、お寄りになってはいかがでしょう。
Oh, man. Ugh. This is bad comedy. Just as I said this, she looked up at me and worried. She answered with her usual smile. You know, I can only hope that Harmonia is a little more upbeat than this, because this is, like I said, bad comedy. It was dawning on me that there was no way that I could correct her tendency to chatter not anytime soon. At least there was the fact that there was little chance that our sounds could be detected from any long distance thanks to this constant pounding of the rain. But the burning problem was... Suddenly stopped as if she read my mind. Since, unlike a human being, her movements were never telegraphed, it was disconcerting, no matter how many times I had watched her. She said apologetically as she stood stock still. Seeing that her movement was possible by a network of old-style micromotors and conductive fiber meshes. This flaw in that particular design was the fact that the entire apparatus tended to overheat quite rapidly when participating in any more than light labor. On top of that, her cooling system was not in the best of shape either. In terms of her manufacture date, she was much older than I was. Although there were probably several chronic diseases lying in wait for me fairly soon as well. Not having any other choice, I headed over to the innermost part of the ease and sat down. She walked next to me, bent her knees, and gently sat down as well. Quietly placed the bouquet on the ground next to her. This was our fourth break already. I opened the cover to my watch and took stock of the time. I didn't feel as if I could calm down unless I could somehow summon a fool who had drawn up her specifications sheet and fire a few rounds to her. If you see why.
Planetarium に客が入るからだろ。
はい、その通りなんです。
だと思った。
はい、以前に館長さんは、雨が降っていると星が特別貴重なものに感じられるんだよと教えてくれました。あるお客様からプラネタリウムの中では傘がいりますかと問い合わせをいただいたんです。
I raised my waterproof cloak a little and unfastened the canteen from my belt. While I drank that foul smelling water, she stopped talking and merely stared over at me.
お客様、お聞きしてよろしいですか？
She said with a dead serious face. So it seemed that there was no longer any way to dissuade her from thinking that I was sick. Stopped up the canteen and gazed up at the sky. Thought about how bad it would be to allow the downpouring drops of rain to strike exposed skin.
ありふれた病気だ。心配することでもない。
はい、申し訳ありませんでした。
Said Isa. Seemed that she had decided that it would be wiser to press no further. Struck me as funny that even someone whose talkativeness could wear out a saint would know that there were certain private matters that should not be broached in conversation. Then again, during the time she worked, it was probably a very valuable skill to know what was okay to talk about and what was not.
ところでお客様は、お仕事は何をなさっているのでしょう？
I hunt snatchers. I mean, I'm a blade runner! She changed the topic as she knew what I was thinking about. So I wonder what the hell was I doing? I answered her and smiled bitterly to myself. She cocked her head in doubt as she always had in situations like these and asked again. Scavenger. Or garbage collector, that works too.
廃品回収業ですか。それは大変尊いお仕事ですね。
She replied with a sweet smile on her face. I was willing to bet that her response would have been the same if she asked a god of death the same question.
私の筐体はリサイクル製を第一として設計がなされておりまして。
Before she could start showing off her abilities, I stood up and threw my backpack over around my shoulder. And as she started to pick up the bouquet without having learned her lesson, I said to her, Just rolls, man. Just roll with it. She presented the somewhat lighter bouquet to me with a huge smile on her face. Stared deliberately at the thing that I was about to throw away onto the roadway. Right, this just proved that I was unlikely to get used to her aesthetic sense. Finally, I secured a bouquet with one of my backpack straps. Even if I threw such a light thing away at this point, it was not as if my burden was decreasing. Whether she knew of my internal struggle or not, she suddenly thanked me. I answered. She then proceeded to snuggle up next to me as if it were a matter of course. We had been walking for roughly 2 hours. An old shopping district spread out before us. Unlike the district of high rises that we had come from, here there were a cluster of low buildings, two stories at the most, crowding left and right around the roadways. And in a mist, one shop in pitiful shape revealed itself from the mist of the rain. It seemed that this was once a liquor shop. Half an old wooden signpost that was engraved with the simple legend, Liquor Store. The warped and bent iron plates of what had once been the door shutters, along with chunks of plaster building material, were strewn on the nearby streets, and glass fragments were scattered about. From the destruction, it looked as if the storefront had been torn apart from the blast of a grenade at point-blank range. It was impossible to tell whether this was the intentional handiwork of another junker or collateral damage from a battle. The spectacle of that fresh destruction in the midst of this dead ruin for which time had otherwise stopped was a dissonance and a comb that lost all its teeth. She suddenly cut in.
ある意味そうだな。でしたら、速やかに救援を呼ばなければなりません。
She at once set about her testing, radio communication that she was so proud of, but it was not as if she would receive a response. After 10 seconds, she spoke. She anxiously hung her head. Just how many times I've seen that particular action out of her? I am my grenade launcher again.
Hi,
and she saw me off with a very out-of-place smile, and I carefully approached the door. I surveyed the tableau that greeted me. Fragments of light brown and light green colored grass were dispersed all over the narrow interior of the shop. But I've been present at the time and the moment of impact. I could probably have gotten dead drunk off the stench alone. But time and rain caused everything to sober up. Certainly if I search carefully, I might be able to find a surviving bottle or two. But the current state of affairs will allow me no such luxury. Full of regret, I returned to the entrance and looked at the place. At once been a liquor shop, being beaten down by the rain. Just when I exited the shop, I noticed something green that had hitherto been concealed shining on the side of the footpath. Drew near it, stepping on the fragmented concrete. Just as I thought, this was a bottle of what was probably high-grade liquor. Cardboard displayed had long since rotted away, but the bottle itself seemed unbroken. The moment I stretched out my hand to grab it, the last moment of a pitiful old man flashed through my mind. While the potential for it being such a trap was low, it was still much better to be safe than to be sorry. Surveyed my surroundings. I couldn't see any wires or trip plates anywhere. The other possibility was, at that moment, a hand stretched out from beside me and grabbed the liquor bottle.
Dozo.
I didn't even have the inclination to get angry for her anymore. And so I merely received the bottle in silence. It was a simple cylindrical bottle holding what was unmistakably distilled liquor. I merely broke its seal and opened the plastic cap. This had been the first time that I broached the seal of one of my prizes in the location that I found it in, but didn't care at this point. I drew the bottle to my mouth in order to partake it. An exquisite aroma that, not decayed one bit, filled my nose. This was unmistakably a fine blended whiskey. Smiles spilled out of me involuntarily. While my situation was still as bad as it ever was, I still felt good as if some weight had been lifted off my shoulders. She asked just as I was about to taste the liquor. I passed the bottle before my eyes. She very consciously read the label. Took the opportunity that the chatterbox words of gratitude presented and took a swig of the bottle's contents. I quickly choked. Scotch, the first I had imbibed in months, was so strong that my body vomited it back up. I took another sip, this time in order to savor the flavor. The air that rushed into me from the bottle was saturated with alcohol, and I could feel the warmth of the liquor in my stomach. The way it was said, that just sounded so wrong.
それは残念だな。
in order to do my tolerable robot companion honor. I took another swig. Now, if I can only have some cigarettes, this world would be heaven itself. She simply gazed at the destroyed shop, smile floating to her face. Her shoulders, entirely covered by the waterproof cloak, looked somewhat unstable. The rubble, washed by the unbroken sheets of rain, glimmered a dull silver color. I unsealed the whiskey bottle to its original airtight state, and then secured it into a pocket of my backpack. We took a course northwest from there. Because I had chosen to walk through the alleyways, it was difficult to tell where we were. However, I could tell that I was making progress toward the quarantine wall. I know I'm past my stuff and pump, but I'm going to be doing a little bit more. The air was rife with the stench of rainwater. I could sense no ill from the continuous falling of the rain. This sarcophagus city, having lost its protective dome, was like an open-faced water tank. Perhaps the entirety of the east side of the city was thus submerged in water. And now I'm actually going to stop here. And when I come back, I'm going to continue the same path that I'm going through. When Planetarian returns right after this.